body running off, rules to the basics. I can't be no son-in-law, I can't take the summer off. I make it look good and all, but this is no vacation. All the goons, they respect me and I know it. Watch your words and your...
With Charles Davis, as always, I'm Brandon Gaudin. Charles, you talk about storylines in this one. I think it begins and ends with our two quarterbacks, certainly two of the best in the business.
And nowadays, I don't think you can get by for long periods of time without a top-flight quarterback. The way the game is played, with all the responsibility he has and how the game flows through him, if he's not on the top of his game, your team's not going to benefit at all.
Set now to kick this one away, and off it goes. And they will elect to not bring this one out as our first drive will begin at the 25. Following the fumble recovery, Dobbs. Throw left side, hold in by Pickens. And he's taken down, but able to slip across the 35. The drive starting with a first down, 11 yards on that pickup.
So what do you do if you've got a defense in cover three trying to keep everything in front of them? The answer seems obvious. Just work those routes in front of them. This is going to be a hitch route, but he's operating in plenty of space, and he makes the catch here for a first down.
And a five-yard gain gets him to the 42.
That was a really nice job by them picking up the run blitz and detecting it and blocking it and turning it into a nice run. And a lot of times you think if you blitz a running play, you're going to smother it. But a lot of the blitzers, they come in a little bit high. They don't have great leverage, and they're easily blocked and turned to the side.
And he's dropped just before the line to gain. Four-yard pickup leaves him with third and one.
If you're a football guy, that's a pretty run because everyone is in sync right there. Obviously, the guy carrying the ball, but how about the people up front? Leverage, athleticism, they created some nice space for him.
They'll run for it with Achan. And he gets it down to the 48, enough for the first. An effective 7-yard third down conversion.
I don't know about you, but that almost felt like old-time football there. Third and two is not necessarily just a running down anymore. A lot of times they want to throw the ball. They went back to the roots and powered forward and got the first down.
So here's a first and 10 now in Raider territory at the 48-yard line.
Kirk, Kirk. 18 Cardinal.
Back to throw Dobbs. Man open, that's complete to Dalton Schultz. And they'll wind up getting this one all the way down inside the 20. The catch and run pays off for 29 yards. We're scoreless after one. Back with Charles Davis, I'm Brandon Gaudin. The offense already on the field here to begin quarter number two. As they've got it with a first and 10. Here's Achan. And he'll get him inside the 15 down to the 14-yard line. 5 yards is the tally on first down. That brings up second and five.
Hey, when you get good yardage like that on first down, it really does a whole lot of good for your entire offense. But I love the way he's finishing those runs. At the end of things, he's making sure he gets just a little bit extra.
Ball at the 14 for second and five. They just do get the playoff as he'll look to throw. And he'll go down, brought down at the 20-yard line. Multiple players combined for their team's first sack of the game.
They've gobbled up over 30 yards of turf so far, but a sack knocks them backwards. And that interrupts the momentum they were building. Good opportunity for the defense to escape this drive before they get to the end zone.
Go here on third down for the eighth play of the drive. Here's Dobbs to throw. And that will be incomplete.
Sometimes the game is pretty simple. Put a few extra defensive backs on the field, give them nowhere to throw the football, force the incompletion, and get off the field on third down.
And this one is right through. And we have action on the scoreboard just before halftime. It's 3-0. With some complimentary football there. One side, your defense forces the fumble, and then they drive it down the field. Now, obviously, Charles, they wanted the touchdown, but at least they were able to drive it down and get three out of that.
Yeah, now we'll have to see how the other sideline responds, because they had plenty of time during that field goal to think about that fumble and how they were going to react. What are they going to do when they get the ball back and try and make things a little bit better for their team?
The offense for Las Vegas about set to begin the drive. And with a little under a minute to go, they may try and work their way into field goal range and try to tie up this ball game. They'll wind up getting 7 on the play, and that will bring up second down. Now Montana. And his throw is going to be incomplete.
I tell you, Brandon, this defense is playing with some confidence. Haven't allowed a point yet. Flying to the football. I'm telling you, it's almost 11 to the ball on every snap. Another nice job there to force an incompletion.
Work in the middle of the field, and he's got a man complete. And he's going to get this down to the 35-yard line. Montana going to hurry him to the line. Now a play fake here on first down. And this is caught inside the 5. And we're going to get a timeout with 2 seconds remaining in the second quarter. They'll throw now on the final play. And this is caught. Touchdown, Raiders. Dalton Kincaid as time expires in the first half. And the Raiders have taken the lead here in the final stages of this first half. You knew time was going to run out, so this had to be in the end zone. And somehow they were able to find a window and get it done.
Very easy for us to talk about up here that, yes, all that had to happen. But when time's running down, sometimes your brain compresses a little bit too. They show great poise, understanding of situation, making sure they got to the end zone in order to complete that pass and take a nice momentum into the locker room.
Welcome back. Charles and I settled into the booth ready for quarter number 3. So a 4-point game here as we get set to resume action in this third quarter of play. And that one will bounce out of the back of the end zone, so we will start here at the 25. The offense back out there at the line, ready for their next drive.
Charles, it'll be interesting to see what adjustments this offense made in the locker room. Haven't really been able to get anything going offensively, virtually nothing in the ground attack either. So certainly something has to change here in quarter 3.
And I'm pretty sure their friends from the defensive side of the ball told them exactly that, because those guys, the stop troops, they've been playing pretty well and they've kept them around in this game. Now they've got some time. The running game struggled in the first half. Opposition knows how to focus on defending the pass here. They've got to re-energize that ground game and maybe open things up for a comeback here in this half.
And he'll get it out near the 40 to the 39. 4 yards the pickup, first down. Now Dobbs. This one complete to his fullback out of the backfield. The result, only 4 yards there on the play, and it'll be second down. Here's Achan. Oh, look at the juke. Breaks the tackle, narrow alley. touchdown! Devon Achane, 57 yards, as his guys are able to regain the lead.
I guess when you look back on it, it was just a matter of time until he popped a big one like that. And, you know, at halftime, you and I discussed it. They had done a nice job on him in the first half. But there were a couple of occasions where it felt like he might wiggle out of traffic and take it to the house. Finally here in the second half, that got done.
Now the offense will stay out there. They're going to line up and try for two. Blake Groupie now for the extra point. And it's through, and that makes the lead 10-7. To the touchdown, here's Groupie to kick this one away. Taken at the goal line. And a nice return sets him up pretty good here right at the 30-yard line. The Raider offense set to get this drive started. And, Charles, it feels like we're set up for a good second half here. Came out of the locker room, one-score game. Now the lead has already changed hands. Well, this offense, they've got an opportunity right now to take that lead right back.
Yeah, and it feels like you're going back and forth almost a little bit like a tennis match, right? And we're just, you know, our heads just keep moving. Which side has it? Which side's going to score? How are they going to go out doing it? A little bit of a challenge for each side trying to match each other.
Here's a throw to his running back. It's complete. And they get him down, but not before he takes it across the 40-yard line. Give them 12 yards that time, and a Las Vegas first. On first down, Archer. And he'll be taken down after a decent gain, and that will bring us to the end of this third quarter play. Three quarters in the books. You are watching Madden Ultimate Team on EA Sports. To throw is Montana. And this one too low. He was unable to complete it there, and just not the game that you would expect from him. He's been off the mark really start to finish.
Yeah, it makes you wonder what exactly is going on. Is he a little bit dinged up here, or is he just off just by a bit? Maybe he can get it back in this situation. He'll need to.
Now a shot taken on third down, but it's going to wind up incomplete.
With that incompletion, reality is staring them right in the face. This entire game is down to the next snap.
Where will the pressure come from? Fourth and six now. Gonna try to throw for it with Montana. Oh, and that's gonna sabotage their comeback plans. It is intercepted. Picked by Antoine Winfield Jr. And he will take this across midfield and down to the 48-yard line. When you talk about making winning plays, that is a winning play at this stage of the game. To come up with that interception, huge.
I like how you identified that, because most people think winning plays are the offense trying to get it done. In this case, nursing a lead, they found a way to make a play on that side of the ball and maybe finish things off.
We've got to have two hands on the football here as they run on first down. And he's going to take this ahead for right around 3 yards, but no more than that. Second down. Have to imagine this will be on the ground as well as they come up second and seven. He's going to get it again. Just looking to get forward and protect the ball. And here he'll be brought down a little shy of the 35 at the 36. The Raiders going to use one of their timeouts. And they'll be disappointed to have to burn one there after giving up the first down. A run now from Achane. There he goes, left side. Down the left sideline. Touchdown.
Devon Achane
with his second touchdown of the night. And his guys are going to add on to their lead.
What a huge touchdown that was, obviously, here in the late stages of the fourth quarter as they try to put this one away.
And, Brandon, when they watch the film after this week, they'll be very proud of every rep if they close this game out. Just a few snaps remaining, they can't relax just yet.
They'll look to throw.
Oh, that's into a sea of bodies, and it's intercepted. After the touchdown, here's Groupy to kick this one away.
On the return, here's Dree Archer.
Fielded just outside the goal line. And he won't get this to the 20-yard line as he's down at the 19. They'll come up first and 10 here.
Trying to shake off the interception. He'll look to throw. Dancing to his left. And now look at this. Big gain, but a fumble. It's going the other way. And they'll set up shop in enemy territory at the 45-yard line.
Well, that drive wasn't a case of wanting to put points on the board. It was needing
they
to,
had to
having
had
to, and they didn't get it done.
Yeah, didn't get it done. And now you look at the situation and the point differential, two scores. Pretty much game, set, Matt.
How about the takeaway, though, huh? How about those defense?